Hello. Good afternoon, my children. I hope you're all fine. I miss you seriously. Sorry we couldn't meet as usual yesterday. But let's take this opportunity to learn something. During our previous lesson, we discussed timber. We are still on timber, but today I want us to look at specifically at the properties of the various types of timber that we have around us. Okay, so we are taking a review of the previous lesson we had. We were looking at properties of timber. We went ahead to look at the cross section of timber. I hope you remember the various parts. We also looked at the function of each of these parts. Yeah, so those are the functions. We talk about the root ring, the peak, the south root, the heart root, the medullary root, back part, and cambium layer. From there, we look at what the fiber is, what grains are, and what the structure is. Today, we want to take a critical look at a specific wood. The first one here is Odum. Odum is the local name we know here in Ghana, but on the international market, it is known as Iroko. So Iroko is the trade name. And what are some of the properties? Before we look at the properties, we should know that Odum is very, very strong. And for that matter, it is used for making things like windows and door frames, roofing panels, roofing. Yeah, but you want to put the roofing sheet on the building, you need some framework. And that's the roofing itself. Then we also have what we call paneling. Paneling is pieces of wood that are put together to make, to form a whole item. So that is the roof. Yes, so that is the roof. We are seeing there. These are panels, frames, stuff, window frames. We also have tables and chairs. We have floors. Okay, this one is the floor. So Odum, because of its strength, it is even used for making bridges, wooden bridges, and so on and so forth. Staircase, and so on and so forth. Because it is resistant to insect and termite attack, it is very heavy and strong. It's medium texture of interlocking grain. When we say interlock grain, the grains are in opposite direction. Opposite direction. What we mean is that as some of the fibers are moving or having a rain naturally towards north, another section is also a rain towards south. That's what we mean by interlock grain. So Odum is very, very strong. And because of that, it's used for making a lot of things. It's used for making a lot of things. And I remember recorder, we have door and window frames for roofing, for paneling, for parquet floors. So this is a floor. This one you're seeing here is a floor. Staircase, and the stairs itself, we use Odum to make that furniture, like the seats and chairs that is used in our room. Coach building, that is a boat-shaped building. So many things, sculpturing as well as others. It has a golden to dark brown color, as you can see in this furniture. The next one we're looking at is Wawa. The local name is Wawa, but on the international market, it is known as Ubechi. It's known as Ubechi. What is the color? It is white to pale straw color. Some authors will say it is creamy yellow. That is still the same definition or description. It has its texture is medium to coarse, meaning the fibers are not tiny. They are medium. That's what meaning when you feel, you hold and feel it. Rather than it also has interlock grain, giving a strip of figure. So when it is used, the figure appears nicely. Now, it is quite, it smells quite pleasant when cut new, and then that scent vanishes as the wood dries. However, odum is quite soft. It is quite soft. So for working property, it can be easily machined. You can use a machine or cut. Now, because you can use a machine or cut doesn't mean it is good. As a result of that, it rots easily. It rots easily. It rots easily. And insects termite attack it also easily. It's used for making what we call veneer. It's used for making veneer. It's also used for making cheap household furniture, like the kitchen stool we use. It's also used for making boxes and components, boxes that are used for packaging, components of furniture. Crates that is used for carrying tomato and others can be easily made of guava. We also have to perform work. If you want to build a pillar or concrete floor, you want to build a pillar, you want to build a beam, you want to make lintel, concrete, we need the guava to form the structure in which the concrete will be poured, and that's what perform work. Yeah. So we can see this is the plywood with guava core. That is also formwork meant for receive concrete. So the structure around all these are all metals, and the whole thing looks like a swimming pool that they are building or fishing pond, and they need to erect a concrete wall. So the wawa is used for forming the framework. Let's also look at the next one. The next wood we are looking at is known as cedar. On the international market, this cedar is known as stapeli. The international or the trade name is stapeli. It has golden brown to dark reddish color, and it is quite durable, straight grain, medium fine. Because of it is quite strong and very, very hard. And it has outstanding figure, meaning when it is used to make anything, it appears very nice. Because of that, it is used for making high class expensive furniture. When it's used for making furniture, the furniture is quite expensive. As you can see here, this is office furniture. So then you can see the color, golden, brown to dark reddish. Yes, so this is a high class furniture, very expensive. Yeah, so stapeli is one of the most expensive wood when it is used for making office furniture. The furniture is quite expensive. Now let's go to other properties and other wood. We also have what we call mahogany. Mahogany, the local name in the international front is mahogany. So its trade name and local name are the same. It's also one of the most common timber that is commonly sold. It has reddish brown color. It has reddish brown color. And it is quite beautiful and durable, similar to that of the wood and the mahogany. It's also heavy and hard, resistant to fungi and insect attack. It has even tested. So it also has many uses. Almost everything we use odum for, mahogany is also there. It is for paneling, flooring, household furniture, carving, interior fitting, joinery, and musical instrument. Let's see. So this is paneling. This is paneling. Typical paneling is here. We also have musical instruments there. Then we have household furniture. These are all things that mahogany is used to make. Let's look at the next one, which is emery. Emery is creamy yellow in color. Its trade name is Lydia, Pamrin, and then Eagle. It has different trade names depending on the origin, because it is common in different parts of Africa. So from where it is picked from, it gives its international name. It also has a yellow brown or light pink brown color. With each sapwood, somehow the pillar not clearly demarcated. Meaning, what it means is that as we learn, the sapwood and hardwood, the hardwood become darker than the sapwood. But in this case, the emery, it's difficult to distinguish between the sapwood of the emery and the hardwood. It has medium to coarse texture, and the grains are quite straight. And moderately lustrous. It's actually beautiful. It's actually a beautiful wood. Its color is similar to that of the wawa, sometimes darker than the wawa. And it's quite dusty and irritates your spiritual tracts. Meaning when it is being sown and you are there and you feel the dust from it, you are likely to suffer some respiratory difficulties. It is moderate and quite durable, but it is hard. It is also used for making window and door frames, for furniture, plywood, making, and engineering. So these are some of the items this wood is used to make. So you can see this one. This is door frame. This is paneling. It's for paneling. And we also have veneer. When we talk about veneer, the minor, the plies that we use for covering designed tables. So these days, most of the veneers are vanishing from the system. The Chinese brought them.
Because the Chinese have designed what we call stickers, which look similar to the veneer and easy to fix and carry than the veneer. The last one we're going to look at is called Ofram. Ofram on the international market is known as Afara. It has yellowish brown color and it is moderate, its moderate strength and attractive figure make this also quite attractive. It is hard and has average weight, meaning it is not too heavy or too light, but has rough cost. This is for making plywood as well, joinery work and engineering. So these are some of the things that Afara or Ofram has been used to design. This is a veneer. These are wood boards for paneling, and that is a small box design of the wood. Thank you so much. If you don't understand, if you didn't go, you can slowly play over this video. Grab everything before you touch on the exercise. I wish you good day. Yeah, so.